Attention. Go.
Hello, YouTubers. We've made it to race day. We're at the Bristol Avon Regatta today to race in the single. So I'm really excited to get out on the water that I've been training on over the past few months and see how fast I can go. The regatta itself is the same format as Henley Royal Regatta, so a knockout style. And basically, if you keep winning your races, you keep racing. In the open singles event that I'll be racing in, there are four entries, and so that means there's a potential maximum of two races. Of course, I have to progress through the first race to get to the second race. So that's the focus now, just to make sure I'm ready to go. The race itself is quite late in the day, around 4:30. So I've already had some good training and some good sessions to get myself ready to get onto the water in that first race and go as fast as I can. So we've got some fans here and some guys racing for Pangbourne, and they have some amazing merch. Let's see right here. Absolutely delightful. Good luck, guys. What are you racing in? This is the quad?
Yeah, the quad.
And how many people in your category?
Just three.
Only three, so it wasn't.
Good luck.
Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Have a good one.
Thank you.
Okay, next race is race P21, semi-final of single sculls between crew 152, Yui on the far side, and 153, Monkton on the near side. Okay, you aligned? Yui, Monkton, attention, go!
So I win in the first round, on to the second one. It's always interesting getting to race. This is probably the first time, first short sprint race I've done in a long time. Last race would have been trials, 5K, very different to doing side-by-side sprint work. So good to get out there, good to be on the home stretch, giving it some yam down the course. Now we get off the water, a little bit of rest, a little bit of recovery, and come back on the water.
A little bit of a delay to the next race, so obviously on the erg preparing for the next race, but it's an absolutely gorgeous day, but I'm staying out in the sun to save a little bit of energy so I can get onto the next race and send it down the course.
Get very wet.
Have fun.
Unfortunately, this is when the GoPro died, but I'm going to reenact a race for the Yam Squad. So let's pretend this is the finish line and that is the start line. So we're on the start line, we're ready to go, hopefully facing the same way. And so we have Josh from Hereford here, myself here, and we're off. Josh absolutely sends it off the first 250 or so, and I just end up about here maybe, very close. So I'm like, okay, we've got a race on our hands, Yam Squad. So we're moving down the course pretty much like this the whole entire way. Like, Josh, my goodness, he's flying. And then he comes back a little bit. And then, oh, no, we're not doing that. And then he comes back a little bit, and then we're not doing that. And then we're getting about halfway, and I just seem to get a little bit more on him. And he's just moving back a little bit. But then maybe about 750 or so, little bit of cheering from the back. He presses on, he comes back on me a little bit more. Like, oh, here we go. Got a race on our hands. We're coming up to the last 250 or so. And then I start just pulling away just slightly more back to what it was roughly in the middle of the race. And then we're coming up onto the finish line now. And then roughly about this much across the line.
So, was a really tough race, a really good race to do at the home course here on the Avon. Really happy to be able to do that here. Thanks, Josh, for that race, and as well in the first race, that was a great race too. Always good to get out there and apply the yam. And this race itself, this regatta, the Bristol Avon Regatta, I didn't realize until talking to one of the members here, it's not been around for that long in its current iteration, but it's been around for a long time previously in what some people used to call Henley of the West, because like I said at the beginning, the format is very similar to Henley. It's like knockout stages. And I think I've got a couple of pictures where the like old boats used to line the banks here. There used to be multiple boathouses that lined the banks here as well. And so rowing was a really big part of culture here, and loads of people came to watch. So they're trying to bring that back, bring the regatta back up to what it used to be, and it's great to be part of that today and seeing so many people race, so many people go out there, because knockout racing, side-by-side, one-on-one racing is totally different to say six lanes, eight lanes, or even three people across. Two lanes, two boats is like a much, there's like a lot more strategy involved. There's a lot more, it's like you literally look across whatever side your opponent is, see the whites of their eyes and affect them just by, say, they can hear a bad stroke or a good stroke, or even sometimes there's some grunts or some shouts from an opponent that you can react to or not react to. But it's great to be able to get out there for the first races of the season here on the Avon, getting some 1Ks in. And that will be it for today's episode of Yam Squad. Hopefully you enjoyed it. I certainly did. And as always, remember to subscribe if you haven't already. Hit that like button, and I'll see you in the next episode. Perfect. Thank you very much.